The biggest successes we've seen with technology in math education is when technology is something that really makes thinking visible. A lot of kids are able to learn when they perceive math not just through symbols, but through multiple representations. We need to activate both more linguistic ways of thinking and more graphical ways of thinking, or more visual ways of thinking.
Okay, that makes sense.
Some of the really nice things about sort of virtual manipulatives or bringing the manipulatives into the technology is that you can really focus kids in on the mathematics and focus in on the ideas. Expert mathematicians see number like in a very spatial way. With technology, we can really sort of show that and help kids develop their stronger models themselves of their own understanding of numbers and how numbers interact.
So one kind of feedback is just right, wrong. But what research has consistently showed is if you can unpack the steps in solving a math problem and diagnose the step on which you made a mistake, that is much more helpful to students.
Can we make it really clear what's going on in the math behind them? So not just teach the strategy, you know, but like make it very, very visually explicit, like what is the strategy and why it works.
And you know, every teacher would love to give students personal feedback.
You got it.
Very frequently, but it's just not possible when you have so many students. So technology can really help in that way with making sure kids are getting enough feedback as they learn.
We should challenge ourselves as developers and designers and curriculum makers to think about what can those concrete experiences or those visuals look like at all ages. That is the piece that's going to help a lot of the struggling learners.
Remember, this is about kids and teachers, and learning is something that people do, and that you're going to really need to understand the people side of this to make a working solution.